Welcome to 11th lecture of RF and millimeter wave IC design. In today's class, we'll continue our discussion. So till yesterday, we were discussing about nonlinearity, effects of nonlinearity, and the performance parameters. Today we'll start discussing the other issue, what we mentioned in the beginning of the class, which is nothing but the noise in RF circuits. So I have mentioned this as part A here because we'll be discussing different things. Like we're starting from, we'll just familiarize what is a noise figure. Then we will go and study what is sensitivity and dynamic range. Then we'll come back to noise figure. We will look at how we can express noise, and we'll do the calculation of noise figure for a cascaded system. So that is the pattern what we are following. First, we will do for a single circuit, and then we'll extend that for cascaded nonlinear stages. All right. So we'll start with this noise in RF circuits. So let us start with noise figure. We'll try to understand what is this noise figure. Right. So if you look at one of the difference between analog designers and RF designers. Is one difference is in analog circuits we always express noise of circuit, but in RF we express noise figure, especially noise figure we express in decibels. So noise figure is something what RF circuits or uses or RF designers use the concept of noise figure. So I just want to know from you guys, are you guys familiar with this noise figure through the courses CS1 and CS2? If yes, can I get some response in the chat box? What is your understanding about noise figure? You can respond in the chat box. Oh, okay. Not familiar. This is the first time you're hearing about noise figure. All right, okay. So maybe you are familiar with this term called signal to noise ratio. Signal to noise ratio, that is nothing but the signal available at the input of a system to the noise there, or signal available at the output of a system to the noise which has come across when it passes through the system, right? So noise figure is nothing but noise figure is basically is a measure of degradation of signal to noise ratio as a signal travels through a circuit. So whenever a signal travels through any circuit, noise can get added up. But at the same time, even you can think that signal also can be amplified. So if the signal to noise ratio is degrading at the output of any system, that degradation is usually measured in terms of something called as this noise figure. All right. So in short, we can say this is a measure of degradation of SNR. When we say degradation of SNR, it is definitely when a signal passes through a system, and this is measured by measuring the SNR at input of a system and output of a system. So it can be conceptually it can be shown like this. This is a system. This is the input side. This is the output side. So whatever we are measuring the signal to noise ratio, this is at the input side. Input side signal to noise ratio. And this is at the output side, signal to noise ratio. So noise figure is expressed as the ratio of SNR in to SNR out. Probably you would have seen a figure of merit as SNR out by SNR in when you would have studied CS1. I'm not very sure. So whatever it is, and at this point, you can understand that noise figure is degradation of SNR as it passes through a system. And in general, for noiseless system, so if the system is that is again bringing an idle condition, for noiseless system, we assume that noise figure is equal to 1. Considering that noise, when a system is noiseless, noise will not be added to the system. That is what we conceptually say. And for such systems, noise figure can be considered as 1. Now, noise figure is usually expressed in decibels. So, how we express this noise figure is noise figure, when we express in decibels, we will do this 10 log SNR in by SNR out. And whenever this noise figure, when it is expressed in decibels, we call it as noise factor also. If it is in decibels, we call it as noise factor. But in most of the cases, this is alternately used. For both, we write it as NF itself, noise factor and noise figure. The difference is when we express in decibels, it is considered as a factor. All right. Yeah, so this is just to introduce you what is a noise figure, when especially in an RF system. Right. So we will come back to noise figure after a while, after discussing some other two parameters, and we will see how we can measure or how we can actually derive the noise figure of any system. So what are the things to be considered, or like all such details we'll be seeing very shortly. Before that, let us also study other two important things. One is sensitivity. Sensitivity of a receiver. You can consider sensitivity of a receiver. So these are definitions. I'll be giving you the definition of sensitivity, how sensitivity is defined as it is. So it is the sensitivity is defined as the minimum signal level. It is the minimum signal level that a receiver can detect with acceptable quality by satisfying minimum signal to noise ratio requirements. So this is called as sensitivity. So sensitivity is, it is a minimum signal level that a receiver can detect. So how? By, under some condition. One is by satisfying the minimum signal to noise ratio requirement. So the meaning of that is, say for example, you have a RF receiver, you have an antenna followed by a lot of blocks, maybe filters, amplifiers and lot many other blocks. Now, for this receiver to process a signal, there should be the receiver can process a signal only if there is a minimum signal level. Also, there will be some minimum signal to noise ratio requirements for this particular receiver to process it. So it should satisfy those minimum SNR requirements. Then only a receiver can process any signal. So that minimum signal level is considered or identified as sensitivity. You'll get a clear picture when we define one more. So this is a minimum level. Similarly, there is something called as maximum level. Maybe you will identify the maximum signal level is usually identified as something called as dynamic range. So by bringing both the sensitivity and dynamic range, definitely we will get a complete picture of that. So now I'm trying to define trying to get an expression for the sensitivity, which is a minimum signal level, by bringing noise figure also into picture, right? So are you guys with me? Can I get some response in the chat box? All right, yeah, thank you. So let me write this here. Noise figure is equal to signal to noise ratio at the input divided by signal to noise ratio at the output. This is noise figure. From this, I can write signal to noise ratio at the input as this noise figure multiplied by SNR. This is just cross multiplication of what I have done. Right. Now, if I write in little detail, what is this SNR in? SNR in is nothing but I can write signal to noise ratio as the power of the signal power to the noise power. So in that way, if I am marking it as P signal, which is signal power, divided by P noise. So with reference to a receiver, the noise power is always identified with respect to the source resistance or the antenna resistance. Right. At the input of this receiver, if you're writing the signal to noise ratio, the signal is the signal which is available at the input to the receiver. Noise is nothing but the noise of the antenna resistance. So we usually mark it as RS, PRS, where PRS is nothing but the noise resistance of the noise of the antenna resistance. So RS or the source resistance. All right. So now from this, I can write, okay, let me write this here. P signal is the signal power. And PRS is the noise power. The source is antenna resistance in this case, or the source resistance. Right. Now with this, I can write P signal as just again cross multiplying SNR in into P into RS. So we should understand each and every term what it is. So P signal is equal to SNR in into PRS. Now we have already written an expression for P SNR in here. Now my idea is to bring in this SNR in equation here. So now bringing SNR in equation in this. So if I do that, I can write P signal as, what is SNR in? SNR in is equal to noise figure into SNR out into PRS. This is your signal power, right? Now, if you want to write the total signal power, so I need to do one simple thing. I need to multiply the signal power into the entire bandwidth to get the total power. So if I write something called as total signal power, the power distributed across all the bands, the entire band, so total signal power can be written. So I'm just using a different notation, P signal total T, that can be written as noise figure into SNR out into the source resistance noise into the entire bandwidth. So that I'm giving this notation as B. So what is B? B is the entire bandwidth. Right. So with that, okay. Now, what I have written is the total signal power expression. Now, we started this discussion by talking about sensitivity, where I told that sensitivity is a minimum signal level with minimum SNR requirement. So from this input, the total signal power, I'm defining what is minimum signal level or the minimum signal power sensitivity as P signal minimum. This is sensitivity. So I'll write this as sensitivity. So this is defined as the same noise figure into, in place of SNR, I'll just mention this is the minimum SNR requirement with the source resistance into the bandwidth. So this is defined as sensitivity, the minimum signal power with the minimum SNR requirements. Right. So this is sensitivity. I hope this is clear, because I started from the definition of sensitivity and arrived at an expression for sensitivity. Let me proceed further to express this. So now what I'm measuring, what I'm expressing here is signal power or the signal level. So as in the previous classes, what we did is the signal power is usually expressed in dBm. So if I do that, so sensitivity is equal to, so P signal, this is P signal total. In dBm, right? You can express it as minimum signal level also. So dBm, this can be written as noise figure, which is expressed in dB, plus SNR minimum, that is also expressed in dB, plus PRS, this is expressed in dBm, plus bandwidth. To get this factor, I'm just adding 10 log B to that, right? And it is also known that, or you can even calculate that the PRS value, if you find the noise power associated with the source resistance, you will get this as numerical value as -174 dBm. You can do this calculation. So with that, I can come to a final expression of P signal dBm. I'm not mentioning it as a minimum. If it is sensitivity, it is definitely the minimum value. Still, I'm writing sensitivity as P signal dBm as. I'm bringing that numerical value first, -174 dBm, plus noise figure expressed in decibels, plus 10 log B, this is the bandwidth, plus I'm writing SNR minimum. I just rearranged the terms. Nothing else I did here. I just rearranged the terms. And now if you look at the first three terms, so you should understand the first term here. The first term here, this -174 dBm, is nothing but the power, the noise power of the antenna resistance or the source resistance. The next term is noise figure, which is expressed in decibels, and 10 log B is the total bandwidth. And the last, just I kept the SNR minimum as last. So why I did this is to show that, or to understand the first three terms. The first term, which shows the noise, the noise power of the source resistance, plus the noise figure. When these two things across the entire bandwidth can be identified as the total integrated noise of the system. The total noise of the system. The noise figure plus the antenna source resistance across entire bandwidth can be considered as the total integrated noise of the system. Or this is otherwise called as noise floor level. There is something called as noise floor level. The meaning of the noise floor level is, if a signal should be detected, that should be at least above this noise floor level. That is what you can see that. Now, from the original definition, what I mentioned before, the minimum signal level with minimum SNR requirements. So that minimum signal level should be at least, that should be little more than the noise floor level. Otherwise, even that signal will be considered as noise by the system. Now, if the minimum signal level is slightly more than the noise floor level, it will not be, it will be out of the noise floor level, and that can be easily detected. And that is possible only when it satisfies the minimum SNR requirements of the system, right? So in that case, this can be further written as the noise floor level of the system plus the minimum SNR requirements of the system. So let me finish that here itself. So sensitivity can be written as noise floor level plus SNR minimum, and noise floor level is the sum of the antenna resistance noise plus noise figure across the entire bandwidth. All right. So any questions on this? If you have questions, please post in the chat box. I'll answer for that. 10 log B by 1 milli. I think Vinod, we are not expressing bandwidth in dBm. Rather, we are, in order to express in dB, we are using the factor of 10 log to get it in decibels. It is not dBm. Right, because bandwidth is not a power value, right? I think that is what you meant, right? By dividing it with 1 milliwatt. Yeah, so since it is not a power, it is not a signal level, we will not express in dBm. Rather, we want to express it in decibels. That is why we just use the factor of 10 log. Is that clear? All right, yeah. So moving on, if you have still questions, you can post it, or even we can discuss at the end. I just want to bring in one more. Since we have defined the minimum signal level, we should also define the maximum signal level, what a system can tolerate within. So that is usually expressed with a quantity called as dynamic range. Dynamic range. So a dynamic range is defined as, we call it as DR. Dynamic range is called as DR, and that is defined as maximum input signal that a circuit can tolerate divided by minimum input signal level with minimum SNR requirements. You may definitely identify the denominator factor as the sensitivity, and the numerator is the maximum input signal that a circuit can tolerate. So this ratio is defined as dynamic range. And to understand this further, so what is this maximum signal level a circuit can tolerate? That could be definitely the compression limits or the power supply limits. So maybe I can pictorially show in this form. So for any system, there will be some noise floor level, and a signal can be detected only if the signal is above this noise floor level. So that that is what we mentioned just before. Noise floor level plus minimum SNR will give you the sensitivity factor. So let me mark the minimum signal level as here, and let me mark it as sensitivity. So this is noise floor level plus SNR minimum, and this is the sensitivity level. So if a signal is of this much strength, it can be easily detected by a receiver, right? Now as we just defined here, there is a maximum level also. So I cannot indefinitely increase the input of input signal to any circuit. So at some point, as we discussed before, eventually any system will compress. So I'm just marking this as the this level as the compression limit. Right. Now it is clear that sensitivity is or can be defined as the range between the minimum input signal level and the maximum input signal that a circuit can tolerate. So in that sense, this is your dynamic range. All right. I hope this is also clear and straight. But yeah, dynamic range is a performance metric which is identified and which is defined with respect to all systems, whether it could be data converters, it could be any other analog system. We definitely define something called as dynamic range. But in RF systems, we are more interested to define with respect, because from the previous discussion, you will definitely say that there are certain effects of nonlinearity that we studied, especially the intermodulation terms. And those intermodulation components are coming very close to the fundamental, and it can actually corrupt the desired signal. That is what we have seen from the previous classes. So now for RF systems, especially RF people, we'll look at something a little more elaborate than this dynamic range, and we call it as a spurious free dynamic range. So let us see what is that. So spurious free dynamic range. We call it as SFDR. So to define, so dynamic range is something what we understood now. Now, if I want to know about the spurious free dynamic range, first let us know what is this spur. So what is the, what is called as spur? Any idea what is a spur? Can I get some response? Are you hearing this term for the first time? Okay, yeah, there are responses. Unexpected spectra in a range, random unwanted signals. Yes, any other response? All right, so yes, that is right. It's unwanted. Yeah, those are unwanted or the unexpected signals. So generally, spur is defined as an unwanted frequency component. An unwanted frequency component is called as spur. Now, you may get a little more clarity. What is a spurious free dynamic range? So we are talking about a dynamic range or a range where you can apply input signals. But within that range, or when you apply signal within that range, that should not create any unwanted frequency components, or that should not create some unwanted frequency components that will disturb your output signal. Right. So how we define this spurious free dynamic range or SFDR is, from the definition, you will definitely understand this. That is a maximum, the numerator is the maximum input power for which, so whenever we provide, whenever we increase, so just visualize this, whenever you increase your input input signal level, we know that as your input signal increases, the unwanted frequency components. So what are the unwanted frequency components? The main unwanted frequency component in our context now is the third intermodulation product, right? So as your A increases, the amplitude of this intermodulation components also will increase. But for the dynamic range to be spurious free, what definition says that is, as you, your maximum input power is okay, but for that maximum input power, your IM3 product should not peak out of your noise floor level. I'll just write the definition and I'll explain to you. So maximum input power for which the IM3 products, the third order intermodulation terms, IM3 products lie below the noise floor level. So if it is below noise floor level, definitely those signals cannot be detected. So that is a maximum. So it is a maximum power, but for that maximum power, IM3 product should not peak out of the noise floor level. The IM3 product should definitely reside within the noise floor level. And the denominator is the minimum input power with minimum SNR requirements. All right, so I hope this is clear. If you have some questions, you can definitely ask it now. Otherwise, we'll just extend this and try to understand with the help of an expression. Okay, let me do the same thing here to understand what is spurious free dynamic range. I'm just these are the two output tones, and I'm marking, or this is the maximum input power. Now, by definition, when you have maximum input power, your IM3 product should lie below noise floor level, is what as per the definition, right? So I am marking this as noise floor level. So this is noise floor level. Now, IM3 products, especially if you have two tones at this specific frequency, the IM3 products will be very close to this. So if I mark IM3 product here and here, these two should lie within noise floor level. Now, above that, you have another level called as, this is your sensitivity, and now this range is identified as spurious free dynamic range. The only difference is we have brought in the IM3 components also into picture, because that is something which is important in an RF system. All right, so that's all about spurious free dynamic range. Now we have to arrive at an expression for this. So if there are no questions, I can directly go and write the expression. Otherwise, if you have some doubts, we can clarify that. All right, maybe we'll go for the derivation in the next class. So I'll wind up here. If you have questions, you can ask.